Why don't you pop some more pills and say what you really feel?
Hey, don't.
I'm busting my ass out there trying to save you, and this is what I get.
So, a few days ago, I made this video right here, highlighting just how fun Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League Season 1 DLC looks like. And at that point of time, I had made that video just on the basis of this whole chart of goodies that Rocksteady posted on their website and the trailer they dropped for Season 1. So I had no way of playing Season 1 early and to give you my honest thoughts about it. Well, I played it, I finished it, and you know what? Overall, it's still bad. First off, let's chat about the good stuff, because there's some real gems in there too. Now, I've been singing praises about traversal and movement since day one, and that's not going to change. Gunplay? Solid as a rock. And the gameplay? Still pretty decent. Oh, and the Joker? Yeah, he's got some sick moves too. Even if they don't scream Joker loud and clear, still a blast to play. And yes, that's the only good this DLC has, which, if you're being honest about it, we already had a taste of traversal, movement, and gameplay in the weeks after the game first release. So that's not exactly anything new that Rocksteady incorporated in this DLC, except maybe Joker, but even with that, I have a lot of issues. Now, onto the not-so-great bits. The story, or lack thereof, major letdown. Remember that Suicide Squad Insider episode hyping up Season 1 and the Joker's grand entrance? Well, turns out that's pretty much all we got. Seriously, the lack of narrative content is utterly frustrating, and it honestly feels like a missed chance for some juicy character development, especially with Harley Quinn. Come on, who would want to see some more dynamic between Harley and this version of Joker? Really? And unlocking the Joker is another nightmare. Grinding it out to level 35 ain't exactly a walk in the park. And you know what's worse? Rocksteady takes away all your progress before the season starts. So let's say if you were at level 24 or 25 before the season starts, so when the season does start, you go back to zero and you have to grind from the start. And it honestly feels like they're nudging you to cough up the $10 just to skip the grind. I mean, seriously, Rocksteady, you can do way better than this. I wanted to make this apology video because I hyped up this DLC so much for myself as well as you guys. And I'm very sorry for that. But I need to really ask this question now. How many chances do you give Rocksteady before we can really start appreciating this game? Because honestly, I am starting to believe most people out there that this game is cooked, and there's literally nothing Rocksteady can do to salvage this. I think you already know how they plan to do more than 10 seasons for this game, but I really have a hard time believing, will they even be able to hit this year's schedule of content if things continue to go this way? But I don't know. I may be hating on the game at this point, I may not even be looking at it objectively, and it's too bad, because I really want Rocksteady to improve on what they had already made. I guess in the future, they should stick to single player games, because that's exactly what put them on the map in the first place. Here's hoping they go back to their glory days. And that is it for this video, guys. What are your thoughts on this new DLC? Do you think it has any redeemable qualities? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section and make sure to smash that like button. If you're not subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button for more content ahead. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.